In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use hardware acceleration in Termix using Turnip to get the maximum performance. This video is the continuation of another one I did about hardware acceleration that I leave here and in the video description. I hope you like it. Once we are inside our Debian desktop environment, we are going to go to my GitHub repository. I recommend you to read it enter, but we can go directly to the section about Turnip. Click on the link I leave you and download the Turnip driver we are going to use. Note that it is only for devices with Adreno GPU. Once we download the file, we proceed to install it with the command you see on the screen. Once we have installed the drivers, we will be able to run the programs with the highest graphic power thanks to Turnip. We are going to make a series of tests to check that everything has gone well. To do this, we run the program called GoMark2. If we run it without anything, we will see that LimPipe appears, which means that it is running with the CPU, without graphic acceleration. Now let's see how to use Turnip. In my repository you have all the info, but basically you can go to the benchmarks section to see how to start each type of graphic acceleration. For Turnip, we copy the command you see and paste it in the terminal changing program with GoMark2. As you can see now, it appears as GPU Turnip. You can see the difference with the normal CPU. Now I am going to show you the hardware acceleration with Firefox. I'm going to use a GPU benchmark called WebAquarium. With the CPU, you can see that the FPS are very low. Now let's do the same with Turnip. Unfortunately, it seems that the page crashes, so Turnip is going to give us problems with the browser. The same happens in YouTube, as you can see. As Turnip crashes, so we are going to try to use another type of hardware acceleration, in this case VirGL with Zinc. We need first to start the graphical server in Termix, outside our PRoot environment. We run GoMark2 again and see that the detected GPU changes again. Let's try Firefox again. As you can see, the GPU benchmark significantly increases its performance as we have gone from 2 FPS to 20. I have also tested YouTube, but honestly, I can't see any performance improvement compared to using it without hardware acceleration. I leave a comparison with the Chrome browser so you can see that it really doesn't matter if we use hardware acceleration or not to watch videos. As a curiosity in Chrome, you can check if hardware acceleration is being used by going to the URL you see. We have already tested the types of hardware acceleration that give better performance, but in case you have a Mali GPU and do not work, you can try to use VirGL as follows. Start the graphics server with the command I leave in the repository and run Glmark 2 as you see on the screen to check the GPU being used. Finally, I'm going to show you the test I have done with the game SuperTux Carts. You can download it from the official site. Note that we need the version for ARM architectures. We download the game, unzip it, and proceed to launch it with the different hardware acceleration options we want. I'm going to start running the game without any hardware acceleration. As you can see, I have put a FPS counter at the top. Although it is not completely reliable, it helps us to know how the game is running. I have tried to start a normal single player race, and as you can see, without hardware acceleration, the game is terrible, about 4 FPS. Let's run it again, but now using Turnip, so you can see the big difference. It says that there are 20 FPS, but the game feels quite fluid, without any comparison with the previous case. We repeat the procedure now with VirGL plus sync. We have to start the graphical server in Termix and proceed to launch the game again. You can see how the FPS are higher than those of Turnip, but the truth is that the game does not feel so fluid, so I think it is a failure of the FPS counter, but the game is still playable. Finally, I show you another test game, but it is so light that you can hardly notice the difference between hardware acceleration and no hardware acceleration. If you try other games, let me know in the comments to know how they work for you in terms of performance. I hope you liked the video, subscribe and share.